Now we'll study about refraction at the spherical surfaces. Now, if we consider a spherical boundary which is separating two media, medium 1 and medium 2, which have refractive indices mu 2 and mu 1. Here, just for the sake of analysis, let's consider mu 2 is more than mu 1. And for this boundary, we consider this the center of curvature. Then if we consider the optic axis of the system, which is the line joining the center of curvature with the central point of this spherical boundary, which we define as pole of this mirror. In this situation, if we consider an object placed in medium 1 on optic axis anywhere, then from the point of object, if a light ray is incident on this boundary, then the line joining the point of incidence with the center can be considered as the normal to this boundary at this point. So, this angle will be the angle of incidence I, and as medium 2 here we are taking as denser medium, the light ray will bend toward normal at an angle R. Here I and R we can relate by using Snell's law. But in this situation, if the ray is extended, finally it is meeting out on the optic axis at this point and creating an image. Because if this is an incident ray, this is the refracted ray. A light ray which will travel along the optic axis will pass as it is, because this optic axis will also be the normal at the point we consider as pole of this boundary. So here this is also an incident ray, this will be a refracted ray, and wherever the two refracted rays are going to meet, an image will be produced. Now in this situation we can see if object is located at a distance u from the pole of this boundary, an image is produced at a distance v from the pole of this boundary, then u and v can be related by some mathematical rule, by which we can analyze image formation due to refraction at spherical surfaces. The same thing which we'll see now, that is image formation by refraction at spherical surfaces can be analyzed by spherical refraction formula used for paraxial incident rays on medium boundary. Here this formula is also generally treated as only refraction formula, and this formula is stated as, it is written as, here we write refraction formula as mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by u is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. This is the relation by which we relate object distance, image distance, refractive indices of the two media and the radius of curvature. Now in this situation here you must be very careful that here u we take as object distance and mu 1 as the refractive index of medium of incident ray. You must not write in several books it is written that mu 1 is the refractive index of medium in which object is placed, but you must write mu 1 is the refractive index of medium here in which incident ray exists, and v is the image distance, and we write mu 2 as the refractive index of medium of refracted ray. You must be careful. And R we write as a radius of a curvature of the boundary. Here also U, V and R we substitute by using a general sign convention by taking pole at origin, left and right side, either side you can consider as positive or negative. And along with this, there is one more relation we analyze that we'll study later, that is magnification formula for image formation by spherical surfaces. In next section, let's study this also.